influencers to the north. We are going to cut Florida off from the mainland of our oppressors and float out to sea. Then, the nation of Florida will be free to start over. There'll be no long-ass lines at the log flume or the pirate ship ride when I take over. You and the kids will be able to ride the rides all day. We will have a roller coaster for each and every Florida family.
You know, you're bordering on treason. What you are saying is a very naughty thing, and only because here on pressing issues do we believe so wholeheartedly in free speech are we allowing it.
It's the truth, my friend, the damn truth. And before you start, I am not a racist. I hate everybody irrelevant of other issues. But I especially hate Yankees, by which I mean anyone from Georgia or further north. Build your own theme parks, buy your own sun, grow your own damn mosquito-infested swamp, pal. We're gonna build ourselves a river. FBI, CIA, I don't give a damn. They can't stop us. You should. Yellow-bellied, tie-wearing, bribe-taking hypocrite. What have you done for Vice City up there in Washington?
I've ensured important tax breaks for gun retailers, real estate developers, and I've cut the cost of policing, saving the city 2% or 25 cents per household over a 6-year period.
At the expense of society. Think of the little people. Poor people have no voice in this city. Every time I find a park to meditate in, someone brings in a bulldozer. It's condos. The madness must stop.
So you suggest we just stop making babies?
People need a place to park their boat and trailer and put their swimming pool. You're beginning to sound red, and by that I mean you prefer a hammer and sickle over a hamburger.
I'm not little. I'm 5'5". It's time for corporations and all of capitalism to step aside for naturalism. You're not saving this planet. You're spending it. Your credit is no good here. We can't afford to loan you any more of our nature. Those are our trees. I only wish I could be around a little longer to enjoy it. I feel so old. Someone must take my legacy. I must train a little...
What does the rest of the world have to tell us about how to do things? Build more trains? Have people elect their leader rather than an elite electoral college? Ride a bike to work like a Girl Scout? Or a clown with dietary concerns? No thanks, Vladimir.
I'll agree with that. People from other countries are good for nothing. That's why we have to keep teaching them a lesson. I tell you what makes a real man. A truck to pull stuff and a couch to think on.
I'll tell you. Speaking as a sensualist, and by that I mean a very narrow-minded, big-centered man of peace, and travel. I recently went to Europe. I think everyone should see it for a week. You really see what's wrong with this country when you visit a European utopia. Things like a journey, public transportation, healthcare, rubber shorts, mustaches. When I went to Belize, I helped some villagers clear some land for an environmentally friendly coal mine. We've all got to make some sacrifices if we're going to get anywhere. My dad gave me the money to set up an exciting trust there.
But how does that help the people in Vice City from worrying about whether they're gonna get robbed? What trust?
Flash FM, your miserable, insignificant little life. Taylor, suddenly everyone wants to hang out with you. Flash FM. Flash FM. You owe us your livelihood.
My baby Matilda! What, you never heard of manners?
Thank you. Give me a break!
More.